Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Type 1 Tuesday. I am a frustrated Type 1 parent today. I've been lately. It's so frustrating. This video is for those of you that have Type 1 kids, those of you that are Type 1s yourself. You will totally understand this and maybe be able to help me out, and we can help each other out. But Henry's numbers have been so all over the place. If you are new, welcome. My son Henry is 9 years old. He has Type 1 diabetes since he was two. Check the playlist here if you want to see our entire journey since 2011. So Henry's numbers have been up and down, up and down, up and down, and I just can't figure it out. We had an endocrinology appointment, and the numbers only got worse from there. I sent the numbers in again, and the educator, they got worse again, and I feel like we're worse than we were before we even went to the diabetes appointment. It's kind of frustrating. I feel like our endocrinologist, anyway, she's more focused on lows. Like, she cares way more about lows than highs, where I cannot stand highs. I'd rather her not even look at the lows, because that just doesn't bother me. But she has a zero tolerance for lows, and she'd rather him be high and then deal with the highs later, where I hate high blood sugar, and it just, like, he gets stuck there and it just doesn't come down and he doesn't feel good. And so I hate high blood sugar, and if you've been watching me for a while, you know that. So it's kind of frustrating that our endocrinologist doesn't seem as concerned about high blood sugar. And the clinic that we are at has like two educators. They had only one up until recently, and they're just too overloaded. Like, you send in your numbers and you don't hear back from them for like days, and it's super frustrating. Typically, we just do it all on our own. We do our own changes and we figure it out on our own. But for some reason, the past few months, we have not been able to figure it out on our own, and it's been really frustrating. I decided today, I woke up and I decided I'm taking charge of this today. If no one else is gonna help me figure it out, I'm gonna figure this out myself. And I gave him zero carbs for breakfast. So he's had no insulin since supper last night at 6 o'clock. So he has gone, I mean, and it's 9:30 in the morning, and he's had zero insulin. So I'm hoping that we can figure out basal from whatever time, because he was high all night. We gave correction, correction. I got up at 2:30 this morning and I gave him a correction. Finally, he came down and he woke up at 1:20. So at 1:20, he was perfect. I thought this is a perfect day for a zero carb breakfast. And then all of a sudden now he's over 200. And he's 210 right now. That's with zero carb breakfast. So that means that his basal needs to be bumped up. But when I asked the educator about doing this, she said his body's used to having carbs and it's probably not a good idea to do that. So I don't know. I thought that when we learned initially, that was years ago, 6 years ago, 7 years ago, that's what they told us to do, is zero carbs to figure out basal. Do they not do that anymore? Do you guys do that? I don't know. But I want to know what you guys do when you have crazy numbers. I feel like we need to just scratch everything and start pure day one, like start fresh. And that's why I thought the zero carb thing would be good. So we'll see. I think I'm doing it right. So since he went like this after breakfast and he's 210 right now, that means he needs more insulin. He has testing, so he has all week and next week of state testing, which is super frustrating as well. So his numbers have been all over the place. So I don't know. But today, this week, it's right after lunch, so I think he should be okay with that. It's just the following week that could be maybe messed up and hard with blood sugar numbers. So because he's testing and stuff, I didn't want to give him a low carb lunch too and then have him like starving all day long. So I gave him a really nice lunch with a lot of protein. So I should keep him really stable this afternoon for his testing. And then I did not send a snack today. He didn't want a snack. So he said that with the testing, they're not having snacks. I don't know. So then I can tell after school, he's been coming home sky high. And I couldn't tell, is it the snack ratio? Does he need more insulin for snack? Or is basal raising at that time? And then I didn't know if it's after school. We gave a correction that he's double arrows down before supper and going low. Is it the correction factor? Oh, you guys, diabetes is so hard. Sometimes it just feels good to hear somebody else saying what they're dealing with and what they're struggling with, knowing that you're not alone, because it does feel like we are so alone in this, because our entire neighborhood, we are probably the only people with a child with type 1 diabetes. even though it's super common, it's not that common. You know, you don't have neighbors across the street that everybody's got type one that you can relate to. It's just not that way. So I'm here to let you know you are not alone. We are in this together and we'll figure this out. It is not an easy disease. It is challenging. It's 24/7, never get a break. I am blessed that we have insulin, we can control it, and we're not in the hospital. He can live a long, full life. We're very, very blessed that it is, that type one, we can treat it the way we are, but it doesn't mean it's not a challenging disease. That is all, guys. Thank you for watching. I will see you next week for another Type 1 Tuesday. I want to do another day in the life, but life has been kind of crazy lately and haven't had a chance to do that. But Henry really enjoys those, so it'd be so fun to have him like do it. Maybe I'll do it on like a Saturday or something when he can film his day in the life. He would enjoy that. So, all right, guys, thanks for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Share it with your friends if you know anybody else that has type 1 or a child with type 1. And I will see you soon. Bye.
Here is Henry's breakfast this morning. It is a 2-egg cheese omelet with 2 sausages. And his number is currently 106 stable. So we know that basal right now is good. So that is a good thing. How's the omelet, Henry?
Good.
We got Mikey here too. There's an Evan James are over there. I want to say good morning.
Good morning.
All of our boys are having breakfast. So this is what I'm doing. So last night, 9:42 p.m., I increased temp basal because he was going up. 9:50, I end up correcting him a little bit. 11:22 p.m., he was 279. Andy gave him this 1.95 units. I woke up at 2:27 a.m. and he was 301, and I gave a correction, 2.5 unit correction, and then he woke up at 7:20 at 120. I gave zero insulin, and I gave 2-egg cheese omelet sausages, and then this is just what we've been dealing with lately. And that's where we're at. So that's what I'm doing.